Hey guys, welcome to Catchy Reviews with Catchy Tales. If you are a fan of mystery thriller like me, then you are gonna love this tech thriller. This novel is based upon one of the most prominent concepts in tech world, cryptography. Published in 1998, Digital Fortress is written by Dan Brown. This is my second Dan Brown novel review. You can also check out my first review of the novel, Origin. Link is in the description below. Similar to Brown's other books, Digital Fortress is also a spicy blend of captivating storyline, meticulously crafted characters, all thrown into one fast-paced timeline. And at the same time, Digital Fortress is also a wild departure from Brown's usual style of narrating, art, history, paintings. This book is all about technology. And the best part is that you don't even need to be a tech expert to understand whatever is going on. I mean, yes, there were times when I had to Google a couple of terminologies, jargons, but trust me, you're going to love the thrill even if you aren't much of a techie. The book is based upon USA's National Security Agency, NSA, which acts as a watchdog for US government. Now, their crypto team recently has encountered a computer code, which they are unable to break. The fact that even NSA's code-breaking supercomputer has failed to decipher the code sends shockwaves through the department. And to add another layer of thrill to it, the maker of this code has mysteriously died, leaving behind one passkey. What then? The game of cat and mouse begins. The story has two protagonists. One, Suzanne Fletcher, who is a lead cryptographer. Another is David Becker, who is her fiance and a professor. David's and Suzanne's story run parallelly throughout the book, where on one side, Suzanne at NSA is trying all possible ways to decipher the code and gather more information. At the same time, David finds himself in Spain, where he is on the lookout for the passkey. And both the stories keep making rounds to and fro like a pendulum. And to be honest, this has contributed big time to the overall excitement factor of the book. Because it goes like someone is following somebody for something, and just that he's almost there, Brown stops the story right there and just flips to another story, leaving his readers to a cliffhanger. And you feel like, what? Why? Calling Digital Fortress a fast-paced novel is an understatement. The story starts from here, lays down all the fundamental crypto theories. And once you are into it, they start building up the story step by step, brick by brick, to a point where readers start guessing all the possible scenarios to solve the thrill. But once you do that, you're encountered with a situation which makes you change your presumptions completely, and you keep guessing. And just like this, you go on and on without being able to put the book down. Because of this, I could finish the book in just 2 days. If you are new to reading and you want to read fast and complete a couple of books, then you can totally start with Digital Fortress. After reading Digital Fortress, you wouldn't be able to help yourself asking a couple of questions. What is right? What is wrong? Who was the antagonist of this book? Did this book even have an antagonist? The beauty of this book lies in its ability to unroll the stories of all the characters, and it may happen that you might end up empathizing with all the sides. And above all, this book touches upon a very sensitive concern of our age: data privacy. Is it okay to give unlimited power to one person, one institution, to intrude into people's personal data, even if this is for the sake of national security? Well, there is no right or wrong. It's all about perception after all. If you like this review, do hit the like button, drop a comment, and do subscribe to Catchy Takes. For more such updates, you can also follow me on Instagram. Till then, keep reading and stay safe.